I am it. So with it being just full screen, I'm not in focus at all. Look, Mark. It's okay. But too much light before?
With
Do you have
that?
any light back there? Because lights from here is too much. But that's too much, yeah.
About that.
No, that's worse. Now I'm grainy.
How's that?
I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, did you think it's kind of
Well, go back to your where your
yeah.
settings.
I don't know.
Well, this is full screen.
It's this big, but there's no. Oh, you don't have tomorrow?
Until 3 o'clock.
Oh, yeah.
And I can't do anything once they walk in the door, so
Right. Yeah.
I gave up time and came today.
Okay. Sorry.
Yeah. I'm done. After we have this conversation, I'm done. I'm gonna go home, so
Well, that's good. Yeah.
yeah.
Then the question, there's a couple things that I saw that we probably need to just kind of fix in randomness. Hopefully
Okay.
the other two will show up soon. I did put 3 p.m. Eastern time for Wayne, so hopefully that'll
Did you end up having a conversation with him after I got off yesterday?
Very briefly, I talked about what you and I had talked about. I think he was a little upset that we did not keep what he wrote. But
But you did.
I did.
Oh, that you're talking about the task analysis
Correct.
paragraphs or what? Oh, okay.
Okay, hold on, like he's coming in. Hey, Wayne. Do you have sound today? You're shaking your head, but can you hear us?
Got me.
There we
Gotcha.
go.
Yay!
Yay!
Sound and volume, it's a miracle.
Well, I have to do it on my cell phone, and it doesn't work too well for some
That's
reason.
okay. Now hopefully Dave will get in here soon.
Did I get the right time?
Yes.
Yes.
You're funny.
Did you send that thing back out again? Because I got it last night. Did you send another one out?
I sent another one out this morning. Or I guess it was probably technically the no, it was this morning. I sent another one this morning.
Okay.
It came
Hang
from
on.
Aaron.
All
Not
right.
me.
Try to pull it up on my computer.
Yeah, and you yeah, because hers has the most up to date on it. I'm trying to figure out how to move this a little bit so I can see both without.
All right, I got it on my computer now. So,
Okay.
let's see.
Well, should we kind of go start going through part of it, I guess?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hope that David joins in.
Yes.
I look professional. I just walked in. I had my alarm set. I was out there helping put the fence up, and I was
Right.
like, I'm gonna go.
Yeah.
And she said, hurry up.
On the first title page, I know it's kind of a crazy thing, but I'd actually put, should we put instructional design and then in parentheses ISD since it's not defined anywhere?
I don't know. Hold on. Let me look at this other one.
It didn't, well, but I just was curious if we should or not.
Technically, you're supposed to do it at its first use.
Right.
And its first use is in the running head, so I don't know how goofy that would look.
Well, I probably wouldn't do it in the running head, because you can't make the running head different than the title.
That's true. True that.
But I would probably put it in the title, and then like move Google Classroom to the next, like colon Google Classroom, because it'll probably go to the next line.
You know what? Most of the examples I've looked at, though, it does say ISD.
It does. Okay, here comes David.
Yay, we're all on.
Okay, I was just trying to check, since now, unfortunately, Erin, you have the most current copy of it.
I do, but I emailed to everybody. Hopefully everybody got it.
Okay.
Yeah, I got it.
Then the other question is, do we need to put group 4 on the top so that he knows? Like after the title, do we want to put group 4 or just put the names of us? Is that okay?
Probably just the names, because each one of us is submitting it individually, so.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's page 1. We're done.
Moving right along.
Okay. So did anyone have anything on page 2 that they needed to fix?
Let me have it pulled up. I thought I did.
I didn't see anything. I don't know what's been touched since I got the document last night.
Nothing. As far as okay. Whatever Erin sent out. Erin sent a new one out this morning. Today. Or yesterday.
This morning.
This morning.
Okay.
It was on whatever email, the Gmail that you had.
Yep.
Sent it to.
I think David commented.
Yeah, it says.
Yeah, okay.
I don't see any issues with it.
The only thing on page 1, we need to put a space after the instructional design, ISD, and then collaborative. I think a space needs to go there.
Agreed. I've got it open. Hold on.
Okay.
Done.
Okay. Anything else on that page? Because I didn't. I tried to change all the Google Classrooms that I could find.
We need to make sure that there's only one space after a period, and it looks like it's correct at the International Society, blah blah blah. But where it says standard 6, I can't check it, but it looks like two spaces.
All right, hold on.
I have to open it now. Darn it. Okay, let me see if I can.
Well, I've got it open in Word, and it's not show. Well, hold on.
She had the cheat on at the top.
I fixed the spacing.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's the.
Here's another nitpicky question. The titles of each section. So looking on, are we on page? Yeah, looking on page 2.
Yeah.
Instructional design, collaborative project, Google Classroom, need identification. Should that be centered on the page?
Need identification is the subtitle, the actual title of the
document. Oh, okay. Here, I see it.
And then that's the subtitle. Because typically what we'll do at the end is we'll have an abstract following this or a introduction into the whole thing, right?
Okay. I added another, like I double spaced between the title of the project and need identification.
No. Single, just the regular double spacing. Like it is, it's set up fine.
Okay. I'll leave it alone.
Yeah, because if you can't put more. I mean, it's the rules. Okay. Are we good with the first page, second page?
Walker is on page 3.
Walker's on page 3. Well, let me move to page 3 then.
All right, here we go, page 3.
That's my goal statement that I completely revamped. Because it was...
It looks a lot better.
Do we have the reference that goes along with the ITSE in 2008 at the bottom of the page?
We do.
Okay.
It looks good to me. I read it again when I went to go do the spell check and grammar check and stuff this morning. So
okay. So then we go down to task analysis. And this is the only spot that I think we still need to add a reference to the Dick, Carrie, and Carrie, because that is one of the things on the instructions. It said using the Dick, Carrie, and Carrie model or the Morrison model, create your task analysis.
But right. But we didn't use the Dick, Carrie, and Carrie because that's that circular flow chart.
Right.
Hold on, I'm trying to get to the right page in this appendix thing.
I know, I don't have Dick and Carrie.
What we could say is using an adapted version of the Dick, Carrie, and Carrie flow chart, because we don't have it exactly that way, but we are using a flow chart.
Did anyone
I got a crazy question.
Yeah.
Why do we even have to mention Dick, Carrie, and Carrie? Why can't we just say, you know?
Well, my thought process was, as he actually specifically says in the instructions, using the blah, blah, blah flowchart.
But if I have it in front of me and the wording is conduct a task analysis based on the identified goal that follows either the Dick, Carrie, and Carrie model or the Morrison model.
Okay. So then
I don't even think we need to mention it at all.
Okay.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. Some of the examples used it, he might come back and say you might want to do it, but I'm fine with that.
It's like a lot of the things that we talked about yesterday, Pam.
Yeah.
If he's going to call us out on it, he's going to call us out on it, and we just adjust.
Right. I agree.
I'd rather learn like that.
Okay.
I mean, and it's the same conversation that we've been having. Some of these directions are not as clear and concise as I would like them to be.
Right.
Leaving us with all these questions. So I guess we'll find out.
Okay.
Once he makes his comments, whatever they are.
Okay. The flow chart. Let me see. I got to move.
The only question I had about the flow chart is the goal statement is shorter here than it is written out above.
Well, because it wouldn't fit on the whole page.
Okay.
I don't know if we need to have everything in there. I just kind of picked the first. Yeah. Part of it, that,
yeah.
It would be kind of redundant to do it over the same exact way again.
No, I agree. I just thought I'd mention it.
Yeah, I tried it. I just couldn't get it to fit on the page.
Okay. I think it looks good.
And yeah, I really did the boxes and stuff. And
yeah. And I really like the change to the goal steps and the sub-steps.
You gave this to me.
I was going to say, Pam, I think you did a really good job combining what Wayne did and what I did and putting the two of them together.
Okay, cool.
That's what I was trying to say. So high five to Pam.
Oh, thanks. So I try to put it together as best I could. So cool. So we're all good with that? There's no spelling issues or anything like that?
I didn't to be.
Okay.
No, and spell check didn't point anything out either, so.
So then we have the context and learner analysis.
And I'll be honest with you, because we had discussed and two of you are from Prince William County, that's why I chose to follow along with that.
That's
I was able to find some statistics to actually make it sound more authoritative, that we have a specific school in mind as opposed to creating one.
Okay.
Sound reasoning to me.
Now, I did add that paragraph that you told me to add, the diversity piece.
Right.
I did not separate it out into two paragraphs because I didn't think it needed it. But you just kind of put it on top, and I wasn't quite sure if you meant that additional section to be a separate paragraph.
No, just I didn't actually address the diversity, and we have a chart talking about diversity, and we had mentioned
and our goal statement.
Google Translate would be fantastic for diversity, and I just thought I should mention it as part of identifying who the learner is and who the teacher is.
No, I agree. Okay. I did change, you kept capitalizing high school, so I got rid of that. Just made it just regular high school, if you didn't notice.
Okay.
Just because we weren't saying what high school.
Right, right.
So.
Teachers are so picky.
Yes.
As I sit here at my desk.
But it is correct. So good catch.
Was there anything, then we get that's it. And then the references, I have the admin, that was the demographics, the ISTE, Prince William County demographics. And that's correct. All we used.
Right.
That's all I could find. Anyone else? Did I miss any?
No, it looks good to me.
The one I'm looking at right now.
Yeah.
That Aaron emailed out this morning. I'm not sure where you were talking about with high schools, but in the last paragraph, during the summer prior to beginning, blah 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 blah. It's high schools is capitalized.
Oh shoot! Where's
all right? Hold on. I'm. What page is it on? Is that on Wayne? Is that
page eight? Yeah.
Oh, I see it. During the summer, prior to the beginning of the new school year, training will be provided. Okay.
Got it. I didn't catch that one. Good job.
Oh, and right up above it, it says the training on how to use Google Classroom. We need to capitalize classroom.
Classroom.
Yep, got it.
Okay.
Okay.
And if you... It might be not be a bad idea to do Control F and type in Google Classroom and make sure that every mention of them are capitalized. Be a good way to catch it. I don't know.
Okay.
But that's all I saw on those two pages.
Okay. All right. So those are fixed and saved. And if we change anything else or not, I'll email out this new one, most recent one.
Well, I'm editing it as we go.
I know, but we have to have the exact same thing. Like,
yeah.
God.
That's why I'm not trying. I'm not even trying to edit. I'm just going to accept what you send me.
Yeah, I've got it pulled up. I'm making all the changes.
Okay.
And then I'll re-email it to everybody.
Okay. Then we can just change it to our name and then send it out.
All right. When I email this to you and you download it to your computers, you'll see up at the top, it's saved as EDUC633_ISD project_rough draft. And you'll see my name is there and you need to change that to your names.
Right.
Okay.
So that's the only thing we're changing is just the name.
Correct.
Right. So when you download it, save it with your name and then turn it in that way.
Okay.
Well, whew, that's one part, huh?
All right. So that went quick. Good.
Week, yeah. Week three bites the dust.
That other crappy part that we have to do. I mean, oh my God, the stuff we have to do next week is just mind-boggling.
I haven't even looked at it.
Well, we looked at it yesterday.
The problem is we, in addition to working on our project, we have to submit it by Thursday for peer review, whatever we have done. Then, after that, we still have to finish our stuff by Sunday, right?
What are we supposed to submit Thursday?
Whatever we have done with the project. So if we've kind of outlined our sections that we have to do this week and fill in, people are supposed to look at those. So by Thursday, we kind of have to have a rough draft of those sections, which are instructional objectives, assessments, and instructional strategy.
Oh, dear God, we're going to have to go back and forth on that before Thursday then.
Right.
To get and the then, objective.
Not only do we have that, we have a video blog individually to do.
What?
Yeah. And it's not an easy one. It's like you have to, you still there?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So we have, due next week is an assessment video blog that we individually have to do. The ISD project peer feedback, so we have to submit by Thursday what we've done completed by then, and then we have to respond to two other people's projects by Sunday, followed by our own update on the design. It's a lot.
I'm going to tap out.
What?
I'm going to tap out on Wednesday night.
You're jumping out Wednesday night? What?
No, I'm going to tap out by Wednesday night.
Well, at least you're only doing one class. I'm doing two, and I have a standards paper right by Sunday. So we'll get
that. I tried that one time, and I learned my lesson.
I do it. I've done it now this whole year, so I'm pretty used to it, but I'm tired. I'm done. Okay, so Aaron, if you can remind me, we said on this, we have the three things, and how do we think we're going to try to do this?
Let me hold in front of me again.
So do you guys have your appendix available?
I don't.
Okay.
I can get it just a second. I got to pull it back up.
You can look online.
Okay. So this week we're tackling instructional objectives, assessments, and instructional strategy. When Pam and I were talking yesterday, the objectives should be fairly straightforward because they're based on those goals, not the big goal, but the four like sub goals.
Right.
So writing the objectives should be simple enough. Yesterday when we were talking about assessments, we wanted to create something fairly simple that's like a pre-assessment for our teachers. How much do you actually know about Google Classroom? How familiar are you with it? And then we would have to come up with some kind of post-assessment after they've reached or received all of their training.
You know, I looked online, and I don't know if we can include this or not, but I actually found a, are you guys familiar with Edpuzzle?
Yes.
Are you guys, are the other two, David?
Nope.
Edpuzzle is kind of like this video system where you can use other people's videos and like ask questions for understanding. And there's actually several Edpuzzles that actually deal with how to set up a Google Classroom.
That would be cool.
I wonder if we could use that as part of our assessment.
I mean, why not? As long as we cite it, right?
Right. And we have it. We can actually put a link in there too. You know what I'm saying?
Let's try that.
Very cool. Yeah.
So I saw that. I just happened because I was looking for an Edpuzzle for my Federal Reserve System, and I'm like, oh, let me type in Google, and I'm like, oh, there's several of them. So I'll send you the link to them, and you can look at them as well. So I'll do that.
Hey, what document are you guys looking at now that I've got my other?
We're looking at the appendix, the assignment appendix under.
It's at the very top.
Yeah.
Where do I get that at?
Course content.
Uh-huh.
And then you go to the first one at the top.
Announcements?
No.
No, go to course content for the first week.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it should be listed there with the syllabus and the calendar. It should be a link you can click on.
Is it module one or organizer script?
It's above module one.
I don't look.
It's under course guides and assignments.
Let me get it up. It says course guides and assignment instructions under course content.
I got it. Okay. Now, what page are we on there?
11.
Looking
at a page. Okay. So
I guess I'm jumping on the assessment wagon.
The bulk of the work is going to, because there are several pieces to that, we need to make sure that we include.
Okay, because each one of those, you need those three things. No, that's in the instructional objectives.
Right, but in the... Right, and that's basically, what do you want them to do? How are they going to do it? And what is the outcome? So that should be straightforward. I think what's going to take the most work is instructional strategies. And how do we break that down amongst the four of us to try and tackle that?
I don't know.
Well, I don't know if I'm volunteering to jump off a cliff or not, but in what I sit here at my desk and do every single day of my life for General Dynamics in the Navy is I write terminal objectives and enabling objectives. And an enabling objective is the exact same thing as an instructional objective.
Okay.
So I can stab at that.
Okay.
Okay.
No, I don't know. You tell me.
I mean, writing objectives is writing objectives. If anything, we might have to change some of the terminology you use.
Right.
Like your employee versus, the way we did it.
I mean, writing an objective is using the language that Liberty wants you to use.
Right. So I think for both the assessment and the instructional strategy is like kind of charts.
That's yesterday. That's probably going to have to be in a chart. That's because I'm at work and the signal is stupid.
Okay.
Okay. Looking at a previous one, this was done. Instructional objectives. They did a brief introduction paragraph. And then they have prerequisite objectives, and they've got three of them. Sequenced objectives, and they've got three of them. Follow-through objectives, and they've got three of them. And then they have just one long table that incorporates all of it together.
Yeah.
God, that seems like a lot.
Yeah.
The table basically just repeats what they've done above. I'm not sure why they do it again, but.
So the example that link I shared with everybody for one project example, they've got theirs as it says goal one, and they, they list what the goal is. Then they list what the instructional objective is. And then underneath that are those three pieces, the performance, the conditions, the criterion. And that's it. That's all they list for right. Each goal.
Yeah, but we don't know if these people got a good grade or not.
True.
I'm just saying sometimes, not that I don't want to do that or use it as a guide. I think it's a great guide, but I just don't want to make sure. Just because it's up here doesn't necessarily. I like how they did it. It works really well.
It looks good.
Yeah, for the goal.
The other, I've looked at several different projects that I just Googled and looked at them.
Yeah.
And they're kind of all written the same way.
Okay.
That sub goal. How are they going to do it? How are you going to assess it?
So the goals are pretty straightforward because we already have our goals based on our paper.
Yeah.
So now we only have...
Right. So in looking at objectives, we had four. Like we had four sub-goals.
Oh, here it is. Okay. So the four goals would be one, get them set up and to test for that.
So that was objective number one.
Yeah. I don't have the new version. I didn't print out the new version. But so we do the four goals, and then underneath it, we write those things.
Right.
So, David, did you want to take a stab at just doing those, or Wayne, you said you wanted to do it.
I tell you what I'll do. If Wayne's going to do that, I'll do the instructional strategy. I'll try to write that up as best as I can.
Well, I think we're going to all have to work on them, right? So once everyone puts a groundwork in, we'll kind of go.
Right. Instructional strategy. I have to create a storyboard or a planning chart. And then we have the media selection as well.
But yeah, but that we don't have to worry about that until next week.
The media election?
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's module 5. Yeah, you're right.
Right.
Thank God.
We only have those three pieces for this week.
Okay.
And what we're going to do is just kind of, even if we get the kind of the framework set up by Thursday, then we have something to
submit.
Yes. So, I mean, the one with the assessments, I think using Edpuzzle is a great tool because it says best practices for distance learning. So to do the pre and the post test. Yeah. How the objectives and assessment. Okay. So you need to still have another, because there's a lot of charts in this one.
I'd rather make a chart all day long than have to write.
I agree. So on the charts, we can always fix them later. I got really dinged in one of my courses on charts. There's not supposed to be any vertical lines in APA formatting. I don't know if you guys ever got dinged on that one, but I did. So if you make your charts, like the box that goes around the chart.
The physical line is not supposed to be there?
Nope. The only line that's supposed to be there is the horizontal line between sections.
Oh, I've never got dinged on that one before.
Oh, I got dinged so bad on that one.
Yeah, I'm sitting here looking at this example I've got. It's got
the lines.
Yeah.
I would have to have something sitting in front of me because you guys completely lost me. I'm not even sure what chart you're talking about.
We haven't made it yet.
I mean, how do you break apart columns if you don't have a...
Well, you keep them there, and then you just remove the lines at the end. So that might be just a formatting at the end.
Oh, my gosh. What class was this for? That you got dinged for it.
My tip.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't. Yeah, I definitely didn't get that on my tip.
Neither did I guess.
My tip writer didn't give us, remember, the actual template. We had to create it on our own. She wanted us to do it from scratch.
No, I have mine given to me.
Yeah, so I think that must be instructor specific because I didn't have that.
Formatting definitely does not have any lines. Oh no, we're running out of time. We have 10 minutes. Just so you know.
We can worry about the stupid box later. Yeah, we've already discussed the important stuff that's actually due today.
Okay.
Right.
So instructional objectives. Who's doing that, Wayne? Who's doing it? Who said they were doing it?
Wayne.
Okay. I'm going to work on this and then on the assessments. And then you're going to take...
I'll start working on the instructional strategy.
Okay.
So what do you want me to do?
Well, I'm probably going to shoot you back and forth stuff.
Okay.
Maybe on my assessments, if everyone wants to kind of throw, is that too much for you? I don't want to overburden you.
That's fine. I'll work on creating the pre-assessment too.
Okay. You can do the pre-assessment.
Like what do teachers already know how to do? How familiar are they?
Okay.
Yeah, I'll see if I can't find one. If I can't find one, I'll make one.
Okay. So you don't want to do like the Edpuzzle thing or do that for the post?
I would save, I'd save that for the, well, send me what you found.
Okay. I'll send you what you found. You can, it's pretty easy to manipulate. You have to create an account. Prince William County has a whole section of, bless you.
Thank you.
Of different ones. So.
Okay.
I'll send all that to you. And it's a good tool for you guys if you teach, you know, any concept that you don't want to actually stand it there and you want to show a video. You can have the whole class answer. Like you can stop it. It stops at a point and it asks them questions. And then that you have to fill it out for you to move forward. So
I've never used that in my class. So I'll have to check that out. I just pulled it up.
It's actually pretty cool. But anyway, and then instructional, you're starting with David. And then we're all going to contribute. So when do we want to meet again?
Let me, hold on. I happen to be looking at my guest calendar. Hold on. Does Tuesday night work for everybody?
Yeah.
Should be okay.
Let's see. Tuesday is the 4th. What time are we thinking?
6. The time, yeah, I don't care about the time. Whatever works for everybody.
Okay. What works for everybody?
It's better for me at 5 o'clock my time, which is 6 for you guys, but I can do 6 o'clock my time, 7 yours.
I'm open either way. What do you guys, David?
6 or 7 is fine. I'm pretty good.
Someone make a decision.
6 o'clock it is.
All
six
right.
6 o'clock our time. That'd be 5 Wayne's time.
6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Okay.
Is that right? So, that gentlemen, works. Are you interested in trying to make one of these Zoom meetings?
Trying to see if I can set it up?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can give it a try.
To set it up, yeah.
I'm saying, I think it's a great tool. I think it's something that everyone should learn how to do. Oh, God, I just broke my pencil. So I think if you don't want to do it, that's fine, too. I'm just saying, though, it's kind of a cool tool if you ever need it for something else.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, David, you're going to do it?
Yeah, I'll give it a shot.
Okay. The big thing is when you do it, you need to make a copy of it and then email it to us, that invitation.
Okay.
So you're going to Zoom. When you log in, you can go into My Meetings and you can start a meeting.
Okay.
Set up a time. So.
All right. I have emailed everybody the updated copy already. So all you should have to do is just download it, save it, put your name on it, and turn it in.
Okay, let's see if I can get there. Where can I get there? I need it. Oh,
sorry, I am multitasking here. Stupid report cards.
So, okay, well, thanks. And so we'll talk on Tuesday. Hopefully people will have some time to get to this.
All right. You guys have a good, great, glorious, and wonderful.
You too. Have fun watching.
You too.
Bye.
See you later.
Bye-bye. I'm going to end this meeting. How do I do that? There we go. Bye.
Bye-bye.